Hello, everyone. Oracle and Microsoft recently announced Oracle Database at Azure that brings the performance and functionality and automation of OCI database services right into Azure Data Center, seamlessly integrated with Azure ecosystem. In this episode of First Principles, let's see how Oracle partnered with Microsoft to deliver Oracle Database cloud services directly in Azure Data Center with the lowest latency possible for mission-critical applications in Azure. I'm Pradeep Vinson, SVP Chief Technical Architect at OCI. At OCI, we believe that our customers must have access to our best-in-class services where they are, even if our customers are using another cloud. With multi-cloud strategy, customers always win. We have been collaborating with Microsoft in building Oracle Database at Azure so that Azure customers have a simple way to use high-performance OCI Exadata service and OCI Autonomous Database service directly from their application, all within Azure Data Center. Now, OCI Exadata system is used extensively for mission-critical applications by customers across the world. Exadata service comes with Oracle Real Application Cluster that allows you to run a single Oracle database across multiple servers, providing high availability and enabling horizontal scaling for traditional workloads. Building on the scale-out architecture, Oracle Exadata combines high-performance database servers, ultra-low latency database cluster connectivity using RDMA, and intelligent storage with unique database-aware software optimizations. Now, on top of Exadata system, Autonomous Database Service brings all the benefits of Exadata, along with the automation that removes mundane database patching and operational activities so that the customers can really focus on developing their applications. Customers can also use auto-provisioning and auto-tuning features of Autonomous Database to right-size their database on the fly. Oracle Database Service in Azure comes with the same high performance, scale, security, and availability and automation that comes with Oracle Database Service in OCI, at parity with what we offer in OCI, but all within Azure Data Center and with a direct private network connectivity from OCI database service in Azure Data Center to the Azure networking. Azure customers can use their Azure credentials directly to deploy and manage OCI database service through their existing Azure portal and SDKs and APIs and use their Azure developer tools. And customers can pay for the services using Azure commercial relationship. This is not a deployment of Oracle Database in Azure itself, but really an extension of OCI and OCI database services into the Azure Data Center. Let's see how Azure customers see and interact with Oracle Database at Azure. First, the customer uses Azure portal or API or SDK or whatever they might be using to create an Exadata instance, and then the customer can create a database cluster inside their subnet in the Azure VNet. After that, customers can create a database instance and then start using it. The databases are presented in customers' subnet via private IP addresses. Exadata service presents single client access name, scan IP addresses, and the clients typically use the scan IP addresses to reach the database. The Exadata subnet can be secured the same way customers do any other subnet in customers' VNet, including Azure network security groups. Let's take a look at the physical data center level architecture. Each OCI region has one or three availability domains, also known as ADs. Each AD can have multiple child data center sites acting as an extension of the OCI AD. The child sites of a region are an integral part of OCI. For Oracle Database at Azure, we built child sites inside Azure Data Center. We refer to the child sites in Azure Data Center as OCI pods. We connect OCI pods to a distinct OCI region that is the closest in terms of physical distance and network distance. Oracle Database at Azure, as well as their key dependencies, are hosted entirely in the OCI pods inside the Azure data center. OCI pods have the same underlying infrastructure as any other OCI region or OCI data center, same Gen 2 network stack, off-box virtualization, RDMA network to power the Exadata service and autonomous database service. The service stack in the OCI pods in Azure Data Center are also the same as we have at any other OCI region. Same OCI virtual networking stack, OCI Exadata service, OCI autonomous service, and so on and so forth. All the security updates, security patching, deployments to OCI pods are all performed the same way. The security controls, operation control, are all done the same way as we do for OCI regions. So essentially, the OCI pods in Azure Data Center act as an extension of OCI region. When customer creates Oracle Database at Azure DB cluster in a subnet in customer's VNet, behind the scenes, what we do is we create a private IP address in the designated subnet in customer's Azure VNet, and then create a necessary VNix in private VCN of the database instance in OCI. And then we create a virtual mapping between the NIC and the IP address in Azure VNet and the VNIC in OCI VCN. A key highlight of the OCI pod architecture is that we have partnered very closely with Microsoft to create a direct private network connectivity between OCI pod in Azure Data Center and the Azure network in the same data center. So when an app in Azure VNet connects to the database service using a private IP address assigned to the NIC of the Exadata instance or the Exadata cluster, if you will, the Azure virtual networking service routes the packets through the direct local link to the edge gateway located in the OCI pod, where the OCI virtual networking stack receives the packets and then forwards that directly to the Exadata service instance in the OCI pod. The direct private network link plays a key role in delivering ultra-low latency between the clients inside Azure network and Oracle database instances in the OCI pod, while also ensuring the network traffic doesn't leave Azure Data Center. Let's take a closer look at what happens when a customer creates an Exadata instance. Customer typically goes to an Azure portal, creates an Exadata instance, and creates DB clusters and databases inside the DB clusters. The API calls emanating from the portal first hit the Azure Resource Manager, which then sends API calls to Oracle Database at Azure Resource Provider, which can be hosted anywhere, but in this case, it's actually hosted in OCI region. The resource provider performs the appropriate translation. It also performs the identity validation, authentication, and authorization. And then finally, it invokes OCI control plane, which then creates and manages the Exadata instance. Note that the customer can just use identity in Azure to invoke the API calls or use the portal. And behind the scenes, OCI will use identity federation to perform the authentication and authorization for the API calls. We're really excited to bring you Oracle Database at Azure. To summarize the key takeaways, Oracle Database at Azure is built using the same underlying hardware and software architecture we have in OCI, essentially an extension of OCI itself. Azure customers can create and manage Oracle Database at Azure using Azure Identity, Console, SDKs, APIs, and so on and so forth, just like as they do in Azure. And they can also pay for it using existing Azure commercial relationship. The database network interfaces are exposed directly on an Azure subnet in customer's environment. Azure applications can access their Exadata instance using the private IP addresses and private networking, just like as they do with any other Azure resources in their VNet. Physical proximity of Exadata and Azure Data Center enables superior network latency performance between the applications in Azure VNet and Oracle Database at Azure. Thank you for joining us today.